Hello, Pre-K.
Welcome back to our school home.
Welcome back. In this video, we are going to do an experiment.
Yay.
We're going to learn a little bit about spring and do an experiment to see what's going to happen and try to understand a little bit more about something related to spring, but I don't want to give it away yet. Before that, I have some pictures to show you. I got a picture of Ariel Kashi's necklace. How cool does that look? Look at that. That necklace is so big and long. Great job, Ariel. Necklace starts with
I'm pretty hungry since I saw that picture. Can I have some Fruit Loops, Mommy?
Oh, does it make you hungry? The next picture I have is of Esty doing her work.
Wow.
While watching Maura Sheeran's video also. I'm so proud of you, Esty, working so, so hard, doing your worksheets, watching these videos, trying to learn as much as you could. And I have a picture of Abby making a creation. Look at that. Her table is full of all different kinds of boxes and materials, and she is building and creating her own invention. I'm so proud of you, Abby. More Gabby and more Shuli are proud of all of you that send us pictures showing us that you're working at home. So let's clap for all of you that you're doing your work. I'm so, so proud of everybody. Now, on to the experiments part of this video. Right now, we are in the season of
Spring. Almost gonna be
summer comes right after spring.
I'm so excited that we're gonna
But what happens? What happens in the spring?
Flowers bloom.
Flowers bloom. Trees get leaves on them again.
It rains more.
It rains more.
And you get more strawberries and plants to eat.
More plants grow.
So you can be healthy and strong.
For sure. Okay, so you guys made a lot of good connections. It rains a lot in the spring. And because it rains a lot in the spring, what happens?
If it's sunny and it's raining, you get more rainbows.
Okay, what else do you get?
Flowers.
Flowers, plants. If there is no rain, will plants grow?
No.
No. We need rain to get our world to be full of plants and beautiful and colorful things that we can eat that grow and things that we can look at that are beautiful. Rain is super duper important, okay? So here's a picture I just have of a plant, right? We love spring plants. It's so beautiful outside. When you go take a walk, you see all the trees have bloomed, all the flowers have bloomed. Everywhere is green and pink and purple and white and beautiful flowers. But we need rain to get these flowers to grow. Even if you're planting in your home, you need to add water every single day and sunlight in order for your plants to grow. So let's talk a little bit about rain, okay? Do you guys know anything about rain that you can help us out with? What do
rain
you know about rain?
Rain gives memory.
Rain gives memory?
Yeah.
Okay, something else about rain.
Rain comes from the sky.
Rain comes from the sky. Great. Anything else?
Rain, rain, go away, come back another day.
What else do you know? Rain comes from the sky. Do you know how rain goes up to the sky? How does rain get up? Does rain stay in the sky? Rain comes down. What happens to the water after it comes down?
It dries up from sun.
Okay, do you know what that's called?
Sunlight.
Lucky for us, you guys are giving a lot of... I have a poster. This is called the water cycle. Okay, a cycle is something that keeps happening over and over and over again. Do you see how there's arrows pointing and it's going in a circle all around? That means it keeps happening. This is explaining to us how rain, this is a cycle of water. So what happens to rain? Where does it go? What happens to it when it falls down? How does it go back up to the sky? Okay, so.
First, it comes from the sky. Then it goes down, all the way to the ground.
Okay.
Then it sinks into the mud.
Okay.
And makes plants grow with their seeds there.
Okay.
And then it all happens again.
What happens again? What's this part?
I don't know.
Well, let's talk about it now.
Oh, and then they grow and they sprout.
So, rain falls from the sky. Where in the sky?
From the clouds.
From the clouds. Rain comes from the clouds. Rain falls down. Okay, these are some big words. This says precipitation. Precipitation is whenever it rains or it snows or when anything falls from the sky. Precipitation. So it rains, the arrow's going down, okay? And the water comes down to our land, to our ground. It goes in the mud to water plants. And it also just stays on the sidewalks or in the streets and it makes little puddles, okay?
I love splashing in this.
You guys love splashing in puddles, right?
And I love playing in the cold, freezing snow.
So then the rain collects on the ground. Whatever gets absorbed, gets absorbed, but there's always extra rain puddles. What happens to it? How come if it rains one day, the next day, there's no more puddles outside? What happens?
The sunshine makes it dry and it goes away.
Yes, that's called evaporation. Pre-K, we learned about evaporation. Evaporation is whenever the rain turns into a gas and goes into the air and it starts going up to the clouds. Okay? Then it gets into the clouds. And when the clouds get very, very, very heavy with rain, wait, let me turn it back.
It starts to rain again. Squishy.
Okay? And then the rain comes down to the ground, then it evaporates, it goes back up. When it gets so full, it comes back down. It keeps going. The rain keeps coming.
Whenever it comes down the clouds, squishy.
Okay, one second. The rain keeps coming down, sits on the ground, evaporates up to the clouds. When there's so much in the clouds, it rains again. And then it evaporates again. And then it rains again. And it just keeps going up and down and up and down.
I have a question about clouds.
What's your question?
When there's thunder, the clouds turn gray and it starts to rain.
Yes, when it gets very, very, very cloudy and gray
and
outside.
And it also makes loud cracks and
yes.
Sometimes you get scared.
Yes, that's for sure. But that happens when the clouds are so, so, so full of water and they're about to burst. Okay? So in this experiment, I want to explain to you how the rain only comes out of the clouds when the clouds are super full of water, okay? So I'm gonna move this camera so you can see. I have, and you can do this at home. I have a cup with water filled up, not all the way to the top, but about, this is called 3/4 of the way. Most of the cup is full, but not all the way to the top.
Shaving cream.
Now, we're gonna add some shaving cream. Shaving cream is going to be our
clouds.
Clouds. So we're gonna fill up as much as we could.
Can I have some in my hand? You just had your cup.
All around. Oh, look at those big puffy clouds. Look at that.
It looks like an ice cream.
Okay, so now we have our, we're going to pretend that the water is sort of like the air.
Ooh.
And our clouds on top.
Mommy,
okay?
It looks like an ice cream.
Now,
like
we're going to pretend that this is food coloring. I'm using food coloring. We're going to pretend that this is water.
I'm putting this in.
Okay? And I'm, can you see? I'm putting some drops on top.
I'm scared of that.
Is it going through the clouds?
No.
Do you see anything coming through?
Yeah, look.
Well, a little bit. But let's see a lot. Let's make it rain. When the clouds get heavy, I'm going to add water now, okay? When the clouds get full of water,
Daddy.
Let's see what's going to happen.
Mommy's gonna go on our table.
That's okay.
What are we using
experiments
this for? Are messy.
Yeah, I think I put too much clouds. When the clouds get full.
Now can we put the green?
What
mommy?
Happens?
What are we doing?
Let's
with the
fill
green?
Up our clouds with water.
I mean, I can put the green one.
Look what's happening. Once I poured tons of water.
What are we doing with it? This?
Only once I filled up the shaving cream, our clouds, with water.
What are we doing with this?
Did it start to come down?
What are we doing
Let's
with
just
this?
Try a different color. Let's
I want to do that one.
Drip some
green.
Green. Let's see if the green's going to come out. It's not coming out yet because the clouds aren't full, but once we fill them with water. Here comes the green. Look at the green. So the blue is there, the green is there, and now it's raining into the water. So only when the clouds get super, super, super full does rain come out. Should we try a different color just for fun?
Yeah.
Let's try. Oh, it's in the kitchen. Can you go get the colors?
What is it?
There's red and yellow. Let's add some more water. Can you see me? Peekaboo. Da 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 da. Look at that. Look at what happens inside.
Can I put the yellow, mommy?
Well, we have green and blue in there. What's gonna happen if we're gonna mix? Put some drops of red.
And now let's put.
Oh my gosh. Our clouds are getting full of redness.
Of bloodness.
Woo! Of here comes the red.
Dying.
Chas v'shalom.
That's yellow.
And now the yellow. Oh my gosh. Now it looks like a real storm. Now it's getting black.
And now
fill up our clouds even more.
And now I'm loving this shaving.
It's fun to play with.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Look at all the colors mixed together.
I can see all you
we
already.
We made a spring storm. So we learned that the little drops did not pass through the clouds. Only until they got so heavy with water did they pop and all of the color came out. Just like rain. When the clouds get so, when there's a little bit of rain in the clouds, they don't, it doesn't rain. Only when it gets really, really, really full.
I have a question.
Does it pour down and water all of our plants and make everything grow? Let's say bye.
I have a question.
Let's say bye to our mug of colors. Do you see all those colors? That actually looks really cool. Have a wonderful day. We hope you enjoyed this fun experiment. If you do it, send us pictures. Have a great day.
Bye.